serve rice and beans, and she lived a very good life, and we pray.
Chimusaga Nenuano, Onina Chukuna Lumuka Munjaga, Chiamale, Aquamona gave for life for a woman, Oconocanduna, Risikanu, Opayaka, and I go. My, wisdom and understanding, Opayaka, and I go.
May her gentle soul rest in peace. Can I have our seat? Then we'll go to the first item of this program. I am not going to be piloting this presentation alone. We have some other people who are my elders yet, who always put me forward. And you know me, I don't need to introduce myself to Premier again, but if you are new here, my name is MC Choice. And I am one of your brother here. So we always come together as one family when something like this happens. We have everything that we want in the building. We are called caution together most of the time. Then we have one of our brothers who is trying to retire, but he's also doing it just sometimes. JJ, when we are not around. And Mr. Campos is also there to help in the music session. So we always work together like this as a family. Then now we have to go to the first item on this program, which is open prayer. Because whenever we are gathered like this, we always give God the rest. So that those that are coming and those that will come, and when we are going home, we'll go home safely without nothing happening to us. Because God is always the ultimate number one, anytime, anything. So I want one of the most elder person here to lead us in open prayer.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In the name of the Father,
Son,
and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father, we thank you for today. Father, we bless your name. Father, thank you that you made it possible that most of us have survived the coronavirus. Even though as this struggle is. Father, bless your holy name. That in brethren, we are united. United is gracious. United also in one and other husbands. Thank you, Father. That our brother, Austin, brought us here together to mourn with him. You said it in your scripture. That it's better to go to where there are money than to go to where there are certain persons. That is what why we are here today to commiserate with you. We are so touched from the mother died to check out the one who lives to us in the age of 60. It's very good. We also think about you, Almighty God, giving the fortitude to bear with us. Ultimately, you know God's plan is the best and God's time is the best. Almighty Father, you also say, cause it to be here today. Help us to live life that has been
about that, we need to do some words of exhortation, which we normally do in the place like this. We have some words of exhortation, then after that we'll give you some words of wisdom, then we'll kick off. Thank you. Do we have the man of God there, the pastor? Do we have? If we don't have that, then is there any man in the... Okay,
let's see. Thank you.
We all know why we are here today. We all know why we are here today. One of us, Mr. Austin, lost the mother. If you look at the poster there, the age is 60 years. Maybe some of us here, we are up to that age, or we are less than that age, to tell you how painful it is for one to lose a parent at that age. Bible made us to understand that there is time for everything. In Levi's, it's written that there is time to be born and a time to die. Like me personally, I've had ugly experiences. I've buried my mother, my dad, even wife. So, Austin, use me as an example. You have to be strong. That's one thing. And the Bible also let us to know that we should not mourn like one that does not have hope. There is hope. Be strong as a man. Some people, their parents died when they were still like 5 years. Like my children today, they lost their mom. The eldest was 40 years or so, but today they are still moving on. All you need to do is to strengthen yourself. If you have junior ones, I don't know whether you're the senior, if you have junior ones, you gather them together. If you are the senior, put your siblings together. If you are traveling, which I know, definitely you are going to go home to give your mom the last respect. Open your eyes. You have to be very, very up and doing. If you are you the eldest?
I'm the first issue, but the first.
Yeah, but you are the one all eyes will be on because you are coming from outside the country. So don't show off. Whatever thing you want to do, you bring your siblings, the ones that senior you and the one you senior you, try to put everything together. Don't allow outsiders to come in between you and your siblings because they will come to divide. You understand? So in any situation, they will ask to bring this, bring the other one, regardless of the age of the person in question, they will expect eating and drinking. So always be calm and attentive to follow things. So don't allow your siblings to overcry. It is good that we bury our parents and not our parents burying us. You understand? Beside the age, be a man. You understand? So God will lead you safely. And that God that will lead you safely to go and bury your mom will also bring you back safely to come and rejoice with us.
Oh.
You understand? We are handing you over to the hand of God.
Oh.
Everything you are going to do will be covered by God. You understand? You go and come back. That's what I have to offer you.
Thank
be
you.
Strong, be a man like me. All is well. Yeah? And maybe the death of your mom will open another channel for you. Okay?
Thank you.
You go in peace.
Thank you. Yeah, that was the worst conversation there. In that offering request of encouragement and all. So normally we use three people to do that. Since he has covered like almost.
Anyway, I greet the house. You see, everywhere is good. We are in Bremen. And Bremen is a city of love. We have all come here from wherever we are to show love to our brother, our beloved brother, Austin. He's a man of the people. Love him so much. You see, Austin, it is well, and it shall be well with you. You see, when we lost our loved one, most especially our parents, you can never be true with it. It will always be in your mind, in your memory. You see, your mom was 60 years, right? My own mom was 54 years. I lost my mom in 1996. That should be 20-something years ago. We were still kids, we are growing up. You know, you will always learn to live with it because I lived with it, because the pain will always be with you. But the truth is, God in heaven knows why. You can't blame anybody. Like what my Sinobola said, they heroes. It is we that will bury our parents. It's always we, not our parents to bury us. So you should be thankful, because the Bible said, in all things, we should give thanks to God.
Amen.
Before the Bible said that, God knows what he's saying, because we can't question God. So as my younger brother, I will advise you, you take heart and you'll be strong. You know why? If you are not strong, this thing can turn you around to a different place where you are going. Because the loss of our loved ones, we can never be out of it. It will always be inside us. And we will always keep it in our memory. So my little advice to you is that as a young man growing, you will take heart and you will live with it. And as you are going back home, here is good. We'll do our own now. Everybody don't do finish. Only you will go out. You start thinking. When you sleep like this, you only think of your mother. You only think of the Lord and everything when he show you. But the truth is that, thank God you have your wife with you. She'll be a very good consolation to you. Because there are some people that lost their parents, they are alone. Because if you have somebody, your partner, that will be there, that will always console you, tell you all is well, it will help you, because you can never come over it. It's your mom, your beloved man, and you lost her in a tender age. She's too young, very young to die, you know? So, but the truth is that you take heart. And when you go home, different from Africa. Africa is a different place. You have to be very, very mature and act wise. Because those elders there, for Benin, we call them Egbe, they are problem. Get us a view. So as a guy, they say we're foolish to get what we want. You just act. Anything they want, give us to them. Then you carry your younger ones. Maybe you are the senior, we don't know. But you have to gather your siblings. talk to them. Because if you, with the, you know, when it's not, if you not feel, console yourself, them too, because they are all looking up to you. So as a man, you will console yourself. But the greatest consolation you have is God, number one, and your wife that is with you. Because I don't want to be the person who will tell you, say, my husband, all is well. If you don't see anything by your back, you will be strong. So, and the wife I talk to, so, madam, yeah, you will be there for him, because it is not easy. It is not easy. I've been through it. Even till now, I still feel the pain of my mom. Because sometimes, when we don't achieve something, the time when our mom wants to enjoy us, we'll lose them. So it's painful to say, your mom will train you all this while. You're not able to give her the enjoyment she really needs. So my brother, let me not take much of your time. Take heart and be strong. It is well and it shall be.
Thank you, brother. Yeah, I'm a new president. That was a very nice one for
you. You know, death is a necessary end. Death is a necessary end. And of course, very inevitable. Inevitable in the sense that people feel too bad when it occurs. And whenever it comes, nobody prepares for it. This is one thing. So it comes like a shock. Just like JJ, our brother, said, you have to hold yourself and put yourself together. I recall sometime 1982, that was, I hope you hear what I said. Sometime 1982 was the first plane crash Nigeria ever had. And it occurred at Enugu. 1982.
Which of your one?
That was Fokker 28. That was the number of the aircraft. Please, can you give us, please?
What happened? You're talking about distribution.
Yeah, the very first plane crash Nigeria ever suffered. As a day. Then, I bet you please, we had a senator then, Senator Ofiamwa. Senator Ofiamwale was living in 2004 building in Victoria Island.
That's crazy.
Yes.
2004.
Shortly after that, whether he was impeached or whatever happened to him, he lost that position at the tail end of that year. And the wife came up in that same position. And the wife went to London, had a baby in London, and came back to Lagos to see the husband. The husband welcomed them and stayed for about 1 week. After 1 week, the wife was to travel down to and then further to the back of the area. The husband of your money had to escort the wife to the airport. That was the first flight, 6 o'clock in the morning. The wife boarded with the housemaid, with all the children, and even the baby. So, as Enugu, the plane had crashed. And the entire family finished. Coincidentally, I was living at Enugu then. And I know one person in that aircraft, a lady, who was helping her, the aircraft, with the little jam. Okay, to cut long story short, one of them while they had that in Lagos, he didn't drop it. The man himself, the wife just passed. So often when he was devastated,
But eventually, like Abakeleke people, they don't bury close to the house. They don't have cemetery. Most of them, they bury in the forest. But I think I attended that area. Along the road, from A Road, by the side. That's where the instrument of the elephant. Sorry, with everyone. At the same time, the government was there. Or the government put for the hand in the state. Even in that same village class, at the Tipa, you know, we were using spade and shovel to put houses inside for the basket. So when Ofewale came back for the day, Ofewale couldn't come. He became dumb for a long time. He was doing like this. Because I was there myself. He was doing like this. But Ofewale survived this. Ofewale is alive still today. You understand what I mean? But you know what it means to him. But he has to put himself together and continue. Another one happened again, Eric, you know it. Recently in Lagos, where people were throwing, what do you call it again? Pure water to paint Mount Christ Lake. A friend of most of us here, Ikebe, you may know him, Ikebe is from Obu, from Abuja. He escorted the family at the airport and they land crashed in Lagos and the entire family finished. Ikebe is today 53 years old. Check out. The entire family finished. So a word is a word for the wise. It's just to encourage you. Like he's from Enugu State, Dr. Wale from Enugu State. They know the family I'm talking about now. Life continues. Just have to get on because the ones under behind you, or I mean your siblings, like you said, look up to you. I gather that you are the first son, is it? Hold on, move on. Life goes on. So that's the much I can say. It's just to encourage you. Life is like that.
My name is Pamela. I'm Austin's wife. Yeah, we are doing now my husband, mother. My husband, we're keeping. We miss her. We love her so much, and we miss her. And he leave us so soon. But God knows the best. I love her so much, and my husband loves her also. My husband's fully so bad to love her lovely mother in early age of 60. But we cannot do. God knows the best. So rest in peace, and she lived a very good life, and we pray we live in heaven. And we pray for God to take care of us, the one that he left behind here. He goes to take care of us and give us heart.
I'm still love for one mama. Oh, hey. I'm still love for one mama. Oh, I'm still love for one mama. Oh, I need a rubola no more. I'm still love for one mama. Oh, hey. Mama pick a basin and you pick on the Mama pick a basin and you chuck on the song. Aqua chuck a wet and you chuck a well to go. Oh, well to go. Oh, well to go. Oh, well to go. No, no, no.
No.
wene wemu. I remember the first time we enter Lagos. Akuta suru lere kamu sibido. Akwa sibelo fu kamu nalaru. Obi inside the ezio imo. Ezio imo. Ezio imo. Ezio imo. Oh no no no. Iwene wemu. Remember the time we love enter Enugu. Akwa sibe flavor kona laru.
Oh, Let's go! I'm gonna go Thank you. I'm gonna go Thank you. I'm gonna go. Chukwudi is again, man. Well done, well done, well done.
God bless you.
God bless you too, my brother. Bless you too, my brother.
Oh,